Welcome to Pioneer of Success. This is the second lecture of the series COMSOL Multiphysics for Researchers. So here is something about myself. So we'll directly move to the technical discussion. In the last lecture, we have talked about four different steps to tackle a physical problem. I'll just recapitulate this. The first step was understanding the physical problem without any knowledge gap, and then clear understanding of differential equation that will guide the physical problem. That means you have to choose your differential equation properly, and that differential equation or set of differential equations should be pertinent to your physical problem. And after that, choice of boundary conditions were very much important, and the boundary condition choice is as much important as the choice of differential equation or set of differential equations. And the last one was feasible values of boundary conditions, space and time. So we have a discussion on all the points, and we took a particular differential equation, that was a diffusion equation, in both 1D and 2D. We calculated the time scale for that particular simulation, and we incorporated that time scale in our simulation, and we have shown how the results were coming and failing to do so, whatever the problems we were facing. So in this particular lecture, we'll be taking a similar equation. Instead of diffusion equation, we have taken heat equation. Then heat equation is very similar to diffusion equation, that is a concentration equation. So here, instead of diffusivity, we are getting another term, that is alpha, thermal diffusivity. And based on the value of alpha, we have calculated a time scale. So here we have taken the alpha value for copper, that is a solid material through which heat will be flowing. So for the time dimension, that is the time scale, is coming around 1 second. So if you put all the values, taking the length of the physical space 1 centimeter, then the value will be coming 1 second. So here we have taken 1 second, 1 centimeter as physical space, because this is the feasible space for heat transfer to take place. So again, I'm telling, these things will come from experience, and that is very much simple, because you already have an idea about how much space is required for heat transfer, how much space is required for fluid to flow. So all these things, we already have some idea, and we have to implement those ideas in our simulation. So again, from 1D we have taken 2D, and in 2D there will be a simple change. So additional del square t del y square will be coming for taking care of the other coordinate, space coordinate, that is y direction. So in this particular case, we have taken a rectangle of 1 centimeter and 2 centimeter dimension, so 1 by 2 centimeter, and that we will be taking for the simulation. And boundary conditions were all the walls that were kept at different temperatures, and for this simulation we took T1, T2, T3 and T4. We'll be putting different values for T1, T2, T3 and T4, and we'll be seeing how the temperature profile within this block is distributed. After doing this, we'll move to another problem. So up to this point, we are taking care of only one physical problem where there was only one physics. So either concentration flow or heat flow. There was no connection between two physics or more than two physics. But in this particular case, what I did in this case, we have taken a problem where fluid is flowing. And fluid is flowing through a channel, the walls of the channels are taken at different temperatures. So there is a temperature gradient mutually perpendicular to the flow. So this temperature gradient will cause heat to flow, and that will heat up the solution or the water which is passing through the channel. So this physical phenomenon we'll be solving, and to solve this physical phenomenon, we need to have two different physics. One is for heat flow and other is for fluid flow. So we have to couple these two equations and we have to solve for it. So the concept of coupling two physics is coming from here. So as a researcher, you have to understand that what are the physics associated with the physical problem, and we should have particular differential equation for all the physics to describe the physical problem. For say this case, we have heat equation. So this is heat equation for liquid. So heat is flowing through a liquid, that is why we have taken convective term. This is the convective term of heat equation, this is the unsteady term, and this is the diffusive term. So we have taken the heat equation. Now for fluid flow, we have taken continuity equation, we have taken momentum transfer equation. So we will be solving these two equations together. Now how these two equations are coupled, you can see here in the heat equation you have a term bolt u, that means the velocity vector. So the velocity vector is coming from this set of equations. So we have to solve this hydrodynamic equation in order to reach to the solution of the heat equation, and this u is changing at every time and in every space. So that is why we have to solve this simultaneously. We cannot do like this, we are solving hydrodynamics then we are going to heat transfer. That is not possible, because u is a function of space and time. So it is varying every time, it is varying at every point. So we have to couple these two. So we'll be showing how to couple this particular thing. So in this particular case, the dimension we'll be taking is 1 cm by 20 cm. The height of the channel will be 20 cm, and the diameter, or you can say width of the channel, is 1 cm. And that is why the dimension, taking these parameters, the time scale will be coming around 14.3 seconds. So we'll be taking 14.3 seconds. So, but one thing we have to keep in mind, and that thing is, in this particular case there are two time scale. One time scale is associated with the thermal diffusion, and other is viscous time scale due to flow, or you may consider convective time scale. But for the time being, we are only considering thermal time scale and viscous time scale. And I have actually calculated the thermal time scale and viscous time scale taking the physical parameters whichever we will be considering for this simulation, and it is coming around, the thermal scale is 14.3 seconds whereas the viscous time scale is 100 seconds. So what does it mean? Basically it means that lesser value of any scale, time scale, means the process is faster, and higher value means the process is slow. So the entire physics or entire phenomenon will be governed by viscous time scale. But another thing is, if you have a convection, that you are the fluid is flowing through the channel with a very high velocity, then you will have another time scale, convective time scale, and you can actually calculate the convective time scale. But in, you should have idea of all the time scales associated with your physical problem, and then you choose your time space. Whenever in COMSOL you have to put the range and the end time, that concept will come from this calculations, and you have to do this calculations piecewise in order to reach to your COMSOL simulation. So now we'll be going to COMSOL simulation, and before that I would like to request you to subscribe to my channel, and also you can feel free to write us for any kind of research collaboration. So now we'll be moving to COMSOL interface. So here we have taken the COMSOL interface. Now we'll click on model wizard, and we'll click on 2D because we'll be solving heat equation for 2D. We click on it. The first problem was heat equation in solid. So we'll be taking, we'll go to heat transfer, we'll expand it. We'll take heat transfer in solids because we are considering solid state heat transfer. So now I click on add. Then I have to take study. The study is unsteady, I have already told. So time dependent we have to choose. I choose time dependent, click on done. So now the interface is here. So what we have to do, we have to choose the geometry. I have told you we'll be taking geometry in centimeter. So I change it to centimeter, right click on it, take a rectangle. The dimension of rectangle height was 2 and the width was 1. I click on build selected. So my space is here. Now I have to choose the material. Which material is there inside the block? So I right click on it. I click on add material from library. So say I will be choosing copper. So I write copper, click on search. It will take some time. Yeah, so there are many solid, so you choose the first one. So I choose copper. So this is added. So all the values of the things like thermal conductivity, density, resistivity are enlisted. So choosing material from the library means you are already taking a set of parameters that was defined earlier by COMSOL. So that is the advantage of taking material from library. If you do not find the material, then you have to define all the properties and you have to make your own material. So now I go to the heat transfer in solid. I click on equation. You can see this equation is there. So we are solving this particular equation. This is a convective term, but the thing is, in this particular case we have chosen heat transfer in solid, so there is no fluid flowing, so this will automatically be zero. Other terms, heat source, everything is absent, so we don't have to bother about these things because we are not putting any values for this particular parameters, and automatically all the values are taken zero. So right part is already zero. This is a diffusive equation because a divergence of Q, and Q is nothing but minus K grad of T, that is your and this thing is coming diffusive heat transfer term. Now what I have to do, I have to put boundary conditions, and there are four boundary conditions. So I take four temperature, right click on it, and I take four different temperatures. Then I go one by one, temperature one, say I click this part, I keep it 293 itself. Then I go to this wall, click on it, put a temperature say 500 Kelvin. Then I go to temperature 3, say this one, keep it say 400K. Then I go to temperature 4, this wall, for the time being I keep it 350K. So temperatures are defined, that means boundary conditions are defined. Initially differential equation or set of differential equations were defined, so the first three steps were done, and all now we already calculated the time scale. It was coming around 1 second for solid, so I can show you. We already calculated that time scale was coming around 1 second for heat flow in solid. So we will be going to study and we'll be putting this value. Before that, let us do our meshing. I click on extra fine mesh, click build all. So this mesh is fine for this particular simulation. Now I go to time dependent study. So automatically the range is zero with an interval of 0.1 up to 1 second. So this will work for this particular case because our time scale is also 1 second. So I directly click on compute. So simulation is running, it will take some time. It is done. So this is the temperature profile. So this part we have taken higher temperature, that is 500K, so that is why the temperature is higher in this zone, and this is how it is distributed. If you click on this surface, you will be getting temperature of a particular point. So anywhere you click, you will get the value. So you can see here the temperature is around 313. So thereby you can simulate. Now we'll be directly moving towards the problem which have been discussed here, that is this particular problem. Fluid is flowing and heat transfer is taking place simultaneously. So we go to a new file, again take 2D. So in this particular case we have to take heat transfer in fluid. We take this, we have to take fluid flow, laminar fluid flow. I add this physics also. I go to study, I click on time dependent, then I click on done. So again geometry, dimensions are in centimeter, so I choose centimeter, right click on it, take a rectangle. So height we had taken around, so for this one it was 1 and 20 centimeter, so height was 20 centimeter. I click on build selected. So this is the space. Then I go to material, I'll flow water through it. So I click on add material library, I type water and search for it. So water liquid is here. I click on this. Yeah, water is there. It is already added. Then I go to heat transfer in fluid. So the equation is again this, for but for this case we'll be adding this U. The convective term will come from the laminar flow. I'll show it later, but before that let us take two boundary conditions. That means we have to define two walls at two different temperature. Say temperature 1, this one, this wall, say it is at 400K, and the other wall is at say 250K. Now these two temperatures are defined automatically, other two will be at thermal insulation. That means four boundary conditions are already specified. These two are at specific temperature and these two are thermally insulated, that we have assumed. Then I go to laminar flow. So in laminar flow you can see these two set of equations are taken. This is the continuity and this is the momentum equation. So what we need to do, we need to add inlet and outlet. So I click on inlet. Let us take this one as inlet. For the time being I keep a velocity say 0.01 meter per second. I click and choose outlet. So opposite side is the outlet. Let us keep atmospheric pressure at the outlet. So in multiphysics, if you right click, there are options: flow coupling, temperature coupling. So whatever you choose, that will make coupling between these two, laminar physics and heat transfer. Now I go to time scale. I already calculated the time scale. The viscous time scale was 100 seconds and the thermal diffusion time scale was around 14 seconds. So let us take some value between 14 and 100. Say starting from 0 with an interval of 1 second, we go up to 40 seconds. Now meshing is not done. We go to meshing, we look for fine mesh, click on build selected, build all. So meshing is being created. This is very high meshing. We go for normal meshing. Yeah, this much meshing is fine for this kind of simulations. So those are physics controlled mesh. You can customize it. We will be discussing about this in another video. So now everything is done. You can click on compute. So simulation will run. It will take some time because two physics are going at a time. So those two physics are coupled. So COMSOL now needs to solve more equations. Because those two equations are coupled, it is solving for heat transfer, it is solving for fluid flow, and then it is coupling. That is why it is taking longer time than it took for the last case. Because in the last case, it was only heat transfer through solid surface. So equations are more, calculations are more. So we'll wait for simulation to finish. Yeah, it is done. So you can see, this is a temperature profile. So this is how temperature is distributed. So it is taking some time, and it is taking some time to diffuse. And after we put 40 seconds, you can see the temperature distribution is good. You can see a distribution. But after 1 second, if I show you, the temperature distribution is not there. That means we calculated the thermal diffusion time scale. It was around 14 seconds. So at least it needs 14 seconds to make a profile. So I'll show you the profile at 14 seconds. So I go to 14, click on plot. You can see the profile is slowly being created. So we already calculated this time scale in our PPT, and then we put 14 seconds. So this idea I had, and I can see that after 14 seconds, the profile is good. So that is why I'm again and again emphasizing that you have to calculate these initial things, and then only you can start your simulation. And also another thing I'll show, what will happen if we put a put an abrupt value, like you put at inlet, if I put a very high velocity, 1 meter per second, then what happens? Let us see. Again, I click on compute. So many times people ask this, errors are coming, like time step is not being converged, at particular time step it is getting stopped. So the main idea is you have to put the feasible values only. If you do not put feasible values, then what will happen? It will be incurring a large number or very small number, and COMSOL cannot deal with that, because behind the simulations are being run, and this is the, those during the simulations high calculations are also taking place. So if any abrupt value comes, it will not tackle that abrupt value, and those abrupt values can only come from a set of parameters which are not relevant to your physical problem. You can see this simulation is not running. Only I changed the value of the inlet velocity and the simulation is not running. So before writing to me, you try with different set of values. You check whether your values are feasible or not. If those are feasible, then the simulation will run obviously. And also you have to make sure that your problem is properly posed. That means your boundary conditions are set, your equations are well and good, and after that only it will reach to a solution. So we will discuss more about it in the upcoming videos. So for the time being, we stop here. Thank you very much for watching me, and please subscribe to my channel.